General Paul Chamberlain, the Air Force guy, RV extraordinaire, coming to you today from Beckley's Camping Center to show you the 2019 Four Winds. This is the 24F. This is a motorhome. For more information on this RV or any others, be sure if you call, if you email, or if you stop by, you ask for the Air Force guy. But let's get on to this 24F. So on the back side of your Four Winds here, you know, of course, you're going to see your bumper. You're going to have your hitch receiver with the 7-way plug. Now, something they've added for 2019, as you can see underneath, is you have electric stabilizers now, so it'll help keep the coach from rocking. So basically the same thing you see on travel trailers. Nice ladder for you to get up on the roof there. And then it does have a backup camera, but they've integrated it into that third brake light in the middle right above Four Winds. So very hard to see that you have it, but you do have one there. Now on your roof, as you can see, very clean, clean roof. They've done a phenomenal job getting this thing together. You're gonna see that you have it. It is already set up for solar panels. And it's also, I'm gonna talk about it, they have the Wi-Fi Ranger installed on this, 13.5 AC. You've got a little power vent fan for the bathroom as well as the kitchen area. Now on the off door side, you know, see, it's a one large slide, which can give you a lot of room on the inside of this small classy motorhome, but then pretty good storage for the size of a camper. Now let me show you. Now starting up the front here, first area is going to be the generator. Nice thing it's not underneath the bed. Then the next you're going to have a little storage here. Nice thing with the storage, you have a light, but you also have, that is for your Swintech slide system. And I will put down on the bottom of this video a link for how to properly operate your slides. And I'll talk a little bit about that when we get inside, but it also shows you what you should be doing if you have an issue with your slide out with that brain mechanism there. So right above the generator, that's where your water heater is gonna be located. So we need to service your water heater. And then this door, this is where you're gonna have your LP bottle. That's all right in there, easily accessible. City water connection, so when you're connecting to city water. And then in the slide out, you're also going to have a nice large outside storage area here. Let me show you that. So you see nice good size storage. Also notice that it has a light for you. And last but not least, on the driver's door side is your larger storage area. Again, well lit. Got a place if you need to slide a table. Notice that it goes all the way across. So that is this particular area, and you can see that door opens up nice and wide. Now on your door side, you're gonna have your fuel fill. Nice thing where this fuel fill is located, it's at the back of the camper, so realistically, if you really needed to, you could probably get away with, if you're at the wrong side of the pump, still being able to use this. But more importantly is that you can see from the side view mirrors where you're located at the pump. Right below that, that is your black tank rinse. And of course, you can see that where you're emptying your sewer is located right here as well. Now storage continues on your door side, as you can see. This is the one we saw all the way going across, as you can see through there. Kind of see a little bit of light at the end of the tunnel there. But this is your storage. Notice how nice the door stays up, so you're not having to use your head to hold it. Your other storage for the wheel, again, well lit, but the door folds down. Now they give you a nice large awning for this motorhome, and it has the LED light strip across that. You could always add lights on the end of the awning tube if you wanted to. And then of course you can see you have this nice 32-inch TV out here with the sound bar. Now that sound bar, you can, it does have an aux in, has a USB. You can also, it's Bluetooth capable. So you can use that for playing music out here. No longer are you having to worry about having the stereo on the inside and outside playing at the same time. So you can see this one is on the E350 chassis. And a lot of times when you get the E350 chassis, you're going to get the smaller V8. This has a 6.8 liter V10, Ford V10 in it. And notice the molded fiberglass cap on the front there. So as you're coming in the door, you're going to see a nice grab handle. Of course, you're going to have the screen door, like most do. You have batteries that are located right under the step here. Notice the step light. So that way there in the middle of the night, you can have that light on. Makes it easy for you to see where the steps are. And then right as you come in the door, this is where, if it already has the solar charge controller here and the connection point up on the roof, if you decided you want to do that. But then you also have for your jacks, nice and easily accessible here versus doing it on the outside. This is for your battery disconnect. The battery disconnect, you connect and disconnect your house batteries. Nice thing with this style of a switch versus a button, once you turn it on, the circuit is opened. So if the batteries were dead, now you can start the vehicle, get the generator started or plug it in, and it will automatically charge the battery. Right above that, this is your step light, and then of course for your awning control. Next, you're going to have your awning light as well as an interior light, and then you have a 110 outlet here. So let me give you a quick preview of the interior with the slide out in. So you see plenty of room for people to sit as you're going down the road. One thing I like about how this ladder is positioned is notice how you can use it with the slide out in. And then of course it has a child safety net for the bed up in front. So as you come in your door as well, right above the kitchen counter, this is going to be your controls for the generator, water pump, tank heaters, water heater, check your levels, your slide, and so forth. So now when you're putting the slide out, there's a couple things you want to check first. Now in order for the slide out to go out, you can't have the ignition on, and you must have the parking brake in the on position down there. So you must have that on, but also make sure that your driver's seat is out of the way, and make sure there's nothing up on the bed area that could infringe on the slide out going out as well. Now back here in the bed area, there's really nothing that should get in the way back here, but you might just want to step back here and look just to see if anything might have fell down between the wall and the slide out at the end prior to putting the slide out. Now when you're operating a Swintec slide system, be sure that you have fully charged batteries. If not, you want to make sure that you're plugged in. The other thing you want to make sure is that after the slide is out all the way, you want to make sure that you hold the button for up to 10 seconds to ensure that the motors align with themselves. They calibrate themselves when they're all the way out. This is on the Swintec slide system. Now this is a typical Ford chassis. You can have electric mirrors, power door locks, power windows. Now this does have the leatherette seats. They are going to be manual seats. You can see you have an HDMI connection port here, USB charger. You're also going to have two 12 volt charging points here, ports here. And then of course this is going to be for your backup monitor, stereo, and it's also set up, it has the antenna on the roof for the Cirrus tuner and the antenna. That's all set up in there. Some of these, you gotta be careful, and some of these when you look at them, you might see where it says Cirrus XM radio, but it doesn't necessarily mean that it has the antenna. With this, you do have the antenna, so make sure you check the specs on that. So I want to come all the way to the back to kind of give you a preview of how much room you have up in the front there, especially since you have this, your wardrobe is in the slide out, unlike some of the other brands that are on the market. Now this does have a 13,500 BTU AC and it is ducted throughout the coach. Now up in the bed area, you're going to see you have a window on this side for ventilation if you wanted to. You can see you have cup holders because directly across from me is the TV. Now that TV can be swiveled so you can be watching it out here on the dinette. You also have a little vent on the roof if you wanted to open that up to let some air in or let some hot air out. And notice you do have the AC ducts up past here because you do have the curtains that come across even with the net in position. Now you might be saying, well Paul, I mean I could see through to the windshield. That's okay. What they have is they do have a net, a privacy screen curtain that's going to go and you're going to attach it here and on through the windshield and that will give you the privacy so nobody can see you through the windshield or through the side windows. Right next to this overhead bed, you're going to have these little charging ports and a little net here so you can set your phones in there or little devices that you might have. So you can be using that whether you're up in the bed or whether you're sitting here at the dinette. Now, in order to make the dinette a bed, it's very simple. It's the way that they do this. What you're going to first want to do is get the cushions out of the way. So we just go ahead and fold them up a little bit out of the way here. Now they're out of the way. And the easy thing is, all you need to do is unlock underneath here, so a little lever, and you're gonna push down. Once it's down, it's down. It's not gonna come back up. And then you're just gonna put the cushions in place. Now the seat belts might create a little bit of an issue for you, but it shouldn't be too tough. And there's your bed. To put it back, we're just going to do the opposite. Move this up here. Get this cushion out of the way. That cushion seems to be out of my way here. This lifts up. Once it's all the way up, you're just going to reach under here and lock it. And now it's locked in the up position. Just a matter of putting your cushions back. By the way, I want to show you something in here that some of you might find helpful. Those of you that have small children. So for those of you that have small children that are still in car seats, what you have is behind here, of course you have the seat belts on this side, no seat belts on this side of the dinette. But over here you do have the seat belts to put a car seat, and then it also has a little tether to tether the top part of that in place. Now on the opposite side, on the front side of the dinette, of course you do have a drawer, and I'll show you that a little later, but when you need to get to the back side of the water heater, this piece right here does remove. And it makes it very simple to get to the back side of the water heater so that you can bypass it for winterizing. And, or, you know, has a little bit more storage, maybe for some small items as well. Now, when your bed is not in use, you're able to fold that center section up and set the ladder up there. You can still have that privacy curtain going down through the middle there, but then that makes it also, while you're driving down the road, you may want to secure the ladder, but that makes it a lot easier for you to get in and out of your seats here. So I want to just give you another vantage point looking through your camper. As you can see, there's a little step up, but notice there's a little night light there, another little feature. This lets you see what it looks like in here. Now for your kitchen, below the oven, you've got a nice big pots and pan drawer. As you can see, right next to that, you're gonna have two drawers, and then the top one is just a little sponge drawer, and then storage underneath the sink. And of course you have the counter extension there. Nice thing with that counter extension, still for most people be able to get in and out of the camper with that up. Look at how large this sink is. Nice and deep, high rise faucet there, and a good window. And that blind no longer has those strings at the end. This thing just lifts up just like your normal regular pull-down shades that you have in the coach currently. Now above your sink here, and you're going to have more storage, but notice how they put two shelves in there and they're both adjustable, as you can see. You got the microwave oven with a little storage above it. This is going to be a three burner Furrion cooktop with oven. Nice thing with this, you see the blue lights along here, but now the oven is also lit up, so you can actually see that through the window. And this sparker, not only does it light the three burners on the cooktop, it will also light the oven for you. Now I mentioned earlier that I would show you the drawer that's down below the dinette. So you can see that pulls out rather far. Some good storage there. And then notice the storage you have up above your dinette booth. Notice how the doors are held up by a metal rod, not plastic, so you're not having to use your head. Now all the motorhomes will come with a window sticker. This is the MSRP. It'll have everything listed for the options in the standard equipment. And contrary to what some people might tell you on the internet, is we do accept offers above the MSRP. Moving back through the coach, right behind the dinette, you're gonna have more storage. You're gonna have these nice long drawers here. You're also gonna have, this is gonna be, you put your trash can here, you can take it, put it wherever you'd like, but nice storage. This is above the outside storage bin that you had out there. It's also gonna have a list of your component serial numbers and item numbers and so forth and what they are in case something happens and they need to be replaced. And then below the drawers, you have a little bit of additional storage. Now in the kitchen, for the kitchen storage, you know, you're gonna want a little pantry. Now look what they have for their pantry. You have the normal storage, you have three of those. But then you also have the pull out. So you're gonna put things down, you have two of these to help with storing some of your dry goods or canned goods and so forth. Now you have a standard RV refrigerator. Now how to operate this, I have that, I'll put that link down below in case those of you that may not have had them before will be able to see how you're supposed to operate an RV refrigerator. And this is what it looks like. Up above the refrigerator, you do have storage, and you have a 110 outlet up there as well. Now, for those of you that had RVs before, whether it be travel trailers, fifth wheels, motorhomes, whatever, you're gonna love the idea of having your breaker and fuse panel somewhere where it's accessible, where you can actually read it. You're not gonna be crammed into a small area where you can't see what they are. You're also gonna notice you have a 110 outlet here by the bed, and then of course you're gonna have your LP and your carbon monoxide detector right below the bed. Now for the bed area back here, you're gonna notice on this side here, on the farthest back here, you're gonna have 12 volt power as well as 110. And the benefit to that is that if you have a CPAP machine, you can run it off 12 volt if need be. You're gonna see nice lights, storage with the doors that be held up, and of course the nice pillows and the cover here. Directly in front of your bed is gonna be where you can mount a TV. And of course, as you can see, this is gonna be your thermostat for your heat and the AC. Of course, you have a light switch there. There is a vent up here, but the only vents in the coach that actually have a power vent fan, meaning you have actual venting, is the one here in the kitchen and the one in the bathroom. Now, if you wanted to, you can upgrade that to the larger vent fan. The benefit of the smaller vent fan is that you do not need to open up any windows in order to utilize it, where the big vent fans, that is something you should do, otherwise you will create issues down the road. Lastly, for that bedroom area, you're going to notice that you have the nice curtain that comes across, Then, of course, you've got the bathroom. Lots of space, an actual porcelain toilet. You see the curved shower curtain, skylight, ACs in here. You also have heat duct inside the bathroom. All that there. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, the 2019 24F by 4 Winds. It's time to check this company out again. They have changed a lot of things, and we're looking forward to having these in stock. For any more information on this particular motorhome or any other RV, be sure if you call, email, or if you stop by Beckley's Camping Center, you ask for Paul the Air Force Guy. Appreciate you watching, and I'll be coming back at you again soon. Take care.